it, we'll start it now.
I'm Dr. Roger Minko, and I'm here today doing pressure testing, and we're studying the new chamois technology and trying to decide exactly where to place the anatomic pads. So the chamois that we have now and the BG shorts that we have now were a big step in the direction of matching the anatomy with the fabric. Now what we're doing is we're studying exactly where the pressure is in the different zones of the chamois so we can make sure that the anatomy lines up in the proper position.
I'm John Knoll, I'm the director for apparel here at Specialized. Today we're doing pressure mapping on our chamois using different test subjects, and we're working with our overseas partner who manufactures the chamois for us. What we do is we have different subjects riding in each of our shorts and then in competitor shorts, and we use a mapping system on a non-padded saddle to see how the different chamois provide different levels of protection and how they compare against our competitors as well.
So we're studying rider's position on the handlebars, on the brake hoods, in the drops, and we're looking at pelvic rotation, and then we're looking at the pressure maps to see where the different position of the bones lines up, and we're correlating that with the different chamois pads and their positions.
Today we're here to examine the pressure mapping system with Dr. Minko to see how the different chamois affect the body in contact with the saddle. The relationship is not a normal relationship, it's a partnership. We developed together starting from the concept that John Knoll brings to the table, and we try to develop together the best solution to protect cyclists.
We know that from the chamois side, pressure affects comfort. And so what we're trying to do is disperse the pressure evenly so that there's no high pressure point on the chamois or the saddles. When we make the body geometry shaped saddles, we have a cutout in the center, and we need to match the chamois with the saddles so that we blunt the pressure of the sit bones, because we're actually increasing the pressure of the sit bones by removing that center section.
Aim number one is to protect the cyclist.